Sure, computers are great at signaling nowadays, but why accept modernity? Embrace nature's signal men. Return to Moltke. In 1881, a man named James Wide was given the job of operating a small signal box for the Cape Town Port Elizabeth Railway in South Africa. Wide was known for jumping between railway wagons and coaches, but lost both of his legs in an accident in 1891, leading him to work as a signalman. To help with his duties, James purchased a Chacma baboon to push his wheelchair and to help operate switches and points. He named the baboon Jack and trained him well. Jack eventually started working the switches more and more, until a passenger on a passing train spotted him pulling the switches. The passenger raised concerns about this with the railway company, and an investigation was launched. When the company found out Jack was in fact operating the points, they verified that he was suitable for the job and decided to just pay him 20 cents a day and an additional half pint of beer a week. James Wide had to remain at the signal box to supervise Jack. Jack worked the points for 9 years, eventually dying in 1890 from tuberculosis. In his short time working, supposedly Jack never made a single mistake, a better track record than most signalmen. It's a wonder really that we didn't have monkeys working on railways more often. Maybe it's because they all escaped and ran for Parliament instead. Subscribe for more.